Hi, my name is Sandra Williams, and you're listening to The Movie Raid.
It's time for The Movie Raid. Tonight's victim is actress Sandra Williams, that is currently playing in Bohemian Soiree, amongst others. Hello.
Hello, thank you for having me.
So tell us a little bit about this project, if you are allowed to, or any other projects that you are currently working on.
All right, well, my first one, the one that is we are filming in 4 days. A Bohemian Story is actually an unconventional story about a bunch of wedding guests who, they come up to the wedding reception for the bride and the groom to find out that the bride is just missing. My screenwriter from Texas actually made the story. I believe it was for a screenwriting challenge she actually made the story on. I have some great Arizona local talent on it. Deanna Hayden, Michael Hanlon are playing the two lead actors, Gloria and Steve. I'm very excited to get my cast and crew together with this project. It's going to be on the 19th of January, actually.
Oh, very cool. Now, you say you also have a production company in the works as well, or still emerging at this point. Do you still currently use that as well?
Yes, I do. I've actually been running my production company for about 5 years now. It's All Dog Entertainment. People ask me all the time where I got that name from. Simply, I Love Animals, All Dog Entertainment. That's where I got the name from. The production company is based out of Phoenix. I actually kind of went silent for about a year or two with my production company, and then I started picking things back up again last year in 2019, and now I actually have two different crews in two different cities, one in Phoenix, one in Tucson, doing things, making movies how it should be.
Now, do you use yourself as an example to continue to establish and accomplish, even though you have this production company, that you could actually just have other films going on and not be the actress in this? Do you think this is more as a step up and added to your career as well, even though you're even going outside? Does this still help you out as well?
Yeah, it definitely does. You know, this is a step up, like you just said, from acting with the whole producing and the directing side. With the Bohemian Story, I'm actually going to be directing that piece. And then with my production company and the same writer as well, we're doing another piece called D After C. And it's a romance novel. It's a 10-page short, but I stepped down from directing on that particular piece just because I connect with the characters so much in that piece. But anything that my production company is going to be producing, for the most part, I will not be acting in. Minus like maybe like one or two shorts here and there, maybe a little cameo like family.
Now, do you divide up your creative roles in between both hats here, between actress and then working with the production company? Do you actually split it up to where it's actually a different effect for yourself?
Oh, well, definitely. Running my production company, man, I feel like I run all the hats. Like, I'm not just a director, I'm not just an actor. Like, I was talking to someone the other day, he's like, you need to classify yourself as a producer, too. Like, you have a production company. You are producing all these shorts. You are more than just an actor and a director. You are a producer as well. And I didn't even consider wearing that hat until, I guess, now.
Now, would you actually offer your production company to actually offer other films that are creating these films? Would you actually almost offer them sanctuary to help them out as in terms of financial stability in some ways, if you get to that point?
Well, yeah, of course. If I get to that point financially, like the shorts, you know, if it gets distributed and everything, I pay all my cast and crew. Like, as far as creating, I built these crews specifically because I love their work. I pull them because I love their creative souls. I like to work with people that have the passion and the drive, like, that you can just see it and hear it when they talk about it. But of course, as my production company, like, if it takes off, I'm taking all my people with me. If you run a production company, there are so many tools that you can use in there as just being, I guess you want to call it CEO of the production company. Like, you wear all the hats, like you were saying. Like, you got the director's hat, you got the producer's hat, and then you got, you know, the casting director's title, all of that incorporated with just running a production company. Like, it's a lot of work. It is. Just producing alone is a lot of work.
Do you think it's best to leave out any, basically, so to speak, outsiders from your company? Do you think it's best not to involve anyone that's still well-established and well-known, their help? Do you think it's best to stand alone and just only help out others who are in the same level, so to speak?
Oh, no. Help anybody. Like, if you're just starting out in the industry, or if you've been in the industry for 20-plus years, and you want to come on a project, like, I don't think production companies should limit themselves like that, if that's what you're referring to.
Good and bad in some aspects, because sometimes there are companies out there that might try to ease in, try to buy up your company, try to buy certain profits, and maybe your company's not making as the same type of deal profits that you're wanting, that you made a deal with that company and so forth. I mean, it's a whole ordeal, so in a way, you kind of have to tread a little bit light just to make sure that you know who to trust and who to actually work with.
Yeah, in that aspect, yeah, sharing the actual production company, very true in that aspect, you are right. You do have to be lenient about, like, who you, I guess, give a little piece of your company to. But as far as, like, coming on as cast and crew, like, it should be open to everybody. I think everybody should be given the chance. But in that aspect of being, like, part owner, I guess, you're right. You gotta be a little leery.
Of course, the actingist perspective. Do you think it's best to almost structure an emotion for a character or combine pieces of other parts of the emotion almost like an alternative to better your performance? Almost, like, instead of just going straight for one specific emotion for a character?
As far as, like, how I necessarily prepare for a role and, like, acting gigs, I've done a little bit of Meisner training and started taking acting classes here and there. But when I first started doing acting, I used to, like, obsess over the lines and, like, try to be that person. But you don't want to become that person. You want that person to evolve into who you are so you can really relate. And a lot of acting, I would say, is being in the now. Do not live in the past. Do not live in the future. You are right here, right now. Acting is being in the now and doing, is what I believe. A lot of acting is doing, if that makes any sense.
There's all kinds of different combinations to use. I mean, either you could stick to the emotion that's already basically planted, or you can take part of an existing motion that you already went through, let's say fear, and then you mix it with comedy. But it, let's say the role is more straightforward. It's not nor fear nor comedy, but you can use those almost to ball it up into something else. Like, it's like a whole different chemistry that you could possibly use.
Yeah, you have to, like, gather their emotions, and like I said, like, when becoming the actual character, you just need to fill out the vibe of the character and bring your own self into it, and then you can just dig deep, fill all the emotions, and just let go as far as, like, scene partners. And that's another thing, scene partners, it just came out of my mouth. If you don't connect with your scene partner, you need to be able to look your scene partner in the eye. You need to be able to connect and feel, because this isn't the correct term, but I don't want to say, if you do have a shitty scene partner, you're not getting pushed, so to speak. You're not getting pushed to the best of your ability. That's how I feel about, like, the scene partner aspect and everything. And as far as one of the projects that I have going on right now, E After C, which is the one that Christy wrote, I had mentioned that I stepped down as the director from that part to play the Chrissy role, just because I connected with that role so much, you know, like, well, because of our Dan and everything. And the Dan character, I feel like, let me tell you a little bit about D After C first. It's a 10-year relationship, a couple of back and forth, 10 years. Chrissy even had a marriage in between the 10-year relationship. I need to be able to, as Chrissy, connect with my Dan like that. And then one of the reasons why I stepped down as the director is because I want my director to be able to push me as Chrissy as well, my Dan character that we find.
As an artist, when watching independent and other larger studio films, does viewing between the two, does it actually have a different influence on you, or even change the way of your perspective view on things as an actor, or even as a producer, or anything else that you might be involved in, watching between the two different, between known and independent film? Has it affect you in terms of influence between watching two different things? Does it influence you in a different way?
100%, definitely. As soon as I started doing filmmaking, like actually making my own films and just sitting and watching TV, I guess, you look at it completely different. You just watch the cinematography and you say, okay, well, I see what they did there. How did they get that shot? You know, just little things like that. And then you're like, okay, I wonder how many takes that took. And then you're looking at the actors, you're like, oh, they're method acting, they're Meisner trained. As being in the industry, you can call those things out more. It's like watching films, and you definitely have more of an appreciation for the arts and what it takes to actually make a film, because it's just not one person or two. It's an entire team that's sitting there putting their blood, sweat, and tears into creating this art that you see on your little square TV right in front of you.
Now, is this film that you, the two films that you currently are doing, does this have any kind of special funding, like, let's say, GoFundMe or anything like that that you're involved with as well, or do you, or are you pretty stable in terms of that to get the project out there?
As far as the All Dog Entertainment production company goes, we just started throwing out their little crowd fundraiser for A Bohemian Story, a little GoFundMe project. You know, we didn't make a concept video or anything, we kind of just threw it together quickly to see if there was any action out there, because we are filming that one in 4 days, so everything is basically set in stone, you know. Like I was saying, as far as running my production company, I pay all my cast and crew. But the GoFundMe's, they're just there for support. They're not do or die. These films are going to get made either way.
But when it comes to indie filmmaking, do you think that it's almost a responsibility for the actor to get the people to contribute and be more encouraged to be involved other than just support the film itself from the viewers? Or do you think it's more of a responsibility on your part? Do you feel like you have to be more responsible for that, not just the company?
I would say, as far as like from the promoting aspects, I feel like that's solely on me. And you know, it would be nice like for the cast and the crew to, you know, share the production page, share the film page. But it's not a necessity. Like, I'm really big on networking and promoting. And, you know, even if you get a post out there a day or, you know, a post or two every other day or something like that, you're networking, you know, you don't want to overkill your people. But I feel like as far as running the actual production company, the promoting, yeah, definitely it all falls on me is what I feel like, which is okay because I love networking, I love promoting, it's what I do. I'm like, hey, check this page out, check that page out, share the production company page, we got this, we're making that.
Do you think now, right now, is a good time to have the actual viewers to be fully a part of these types of films in terms of, you know, contributing to the money toward the projects and stuff like that? Do you think it's now is a good time to get them to be actually feel a part of the movie themselves?
Yeah, I completely agree. Like, especially now time is ever because, like I said, Bohemian Story is filming in 4 days. So I've had a few of my actors, you know, share the Bohemian page. And everyone, you know, everyone as far as, like, the indie scene, like, they've been very supportive of the production company, what we're trying to do. My long-term goal as far as running the production company, like I said, I have two teams in two different cities. I just want to create art. I want to first start off with short films, do a couple short films, maybe like 1 or 2 a month, start pulling them out of the works, and then go on to feature films, like any of that. I'm not even opposed to my production company doing music videos. I want to do it all, honestly. If it comes to film, my production company will do it.
Go ahead and plug in any websites or any other projects that we can check out right now.
So, like I said, we got the FFC going on. We have a Bohemian Story. There's a few other things that's being worked out, and I'm sure my writer will probably eventually end up talking about these ones. A Blind Date and then a film called In Between 2 and 3. Those two films, I don't want to say they're on the back burner, but they're going to be after Bohemian Story and DFSC. And if you go check out the All Dog Entertainment production company page, Facebook, you'll see there's at least 4 or 5 short films that are in the works right now. I think 2020 is going to be like a really good big year for All Dog Entertainment.
And then there you have it, everybody. That is actress Sandra Williams.
Thank you so much.